Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Wednesday, and usually we do that Kauman Crush Wednesday thing that we always do. Now today, I thought about which female I should crush on, and I thought about it. I want to crush on all the beautiful, gorgeous, very open-minded, brave women in our YouTube family. Oh, the chicks who comment on the Scoop on Scoop page. Jesus is the Lord. And not just on YouTube, down to the ones who follow us on all the different social media platforms. So today, I am officially making your My Woman Crush Wednesday. And I just have one more person to crush on. I would like to specifically crush on that chick on YouTube. It's been 5 years of me doing this show. 5! And you always pop out of the woodworks just to ask if I am wearing a bra. Can your attention be... I'm here, not here, not here. Like, this girl get me confused. Like, every time I put up an episode, she's like, it's not my fault I'm an A-cup. Deal with yours. But I'm crushing on you too. It takes a certain amount of consistency, don't it? 5 years, singing the same tune, and there's no change. But I love you too. Other than that, my name is Cinevious One. The show is proudly sponsored by Fanta. Let's get it. I remember the last time I talked about MC Cut, I was like, man, Zenko, you mean to be an MC Cut. And now, more than ever, I think it's making a little bit more sense to the people who are trying to chastise me and tell me, oh, T, that's really, really wrong. You can't be talking like that. I think now you ought to understand where I was coming from when I said, I'm done with the celebrated people in this country taking our empathy for granted. So apparently MC Cuts was seen in a bar on Monday. This is the same MC Cuts who took to the pulpit and gave his life to Christ. I think everyone here is a little more. That's not a big deal. Gave his life to Christ and said he'll be leaving behind all the partying, the drinking, and you know, all that crap so that he can try to get his life back together. Now, on Monday, he was seen at a bar with Caro Casita having a merry old good time, gyrating and doing all these things. I'm like, you know what? Kat is allowed to have, you know, a few moments of letting off steam, but I still believe, isn't that too soon? So what happens when you hit a relapse, when the nightlife is the drug that you always wanted? When you relapse, then what? Then what? Like, the Bible says it. If it is this hand that is causing you to sin, or you cut that one off. Abi, if it is your tongue causing you to sin, Abi, pluck it out. If it is your eye, Abi, you know what to do. Take out. Cuts amanyi why his life deteriorated. Cuts amanyi echamutu sakuchariko. But for some reason, he's half-stepping on life's choices. Like, I believe if I was MC Cuts right now, well, the cat is out of the bag, everybody knows it, and now I have to try and work towards getting my life back. You know, getting it together. But all this guy is doing, I even saw recently, nalabia ya kapanda kalalamba inakapati. He has like a party somewhere. I'm like, is this the... Because, I mean, someone would be like, Atitalia, Tinatalia. But this is the same guy who told us a couple of months back he doesn't need to work. He's on holiday. I mean, he just, you know, he's rich. He has money. What is going on with you Ugandans? I'm on holiday. I can't wait for the day we will wake up in this country and only talk about a celebrity when it is relevant. Only give a celebrity time when it is really earned and deserved. I can't wait. I can't wait. It may be a long time, but it will happen. Let's wait. Anyway, as of now, he's back to his old self. I don't know if he's back to his old drinking self or partying self or not taking meds self or still fighting with the UN people who want to eat UN money. My job is to come here and tell you what is happening with this life. As of Monday, that is what was happening. For the past couple of days, has it been days actually?
I think I even hinted on it on Friday when I was doing the Kampala Sun, and the Kampala Sun was running a story saying that Jeff Chiwa and Sheba are splitting, which means she'll be walking away from TNS. And I also remember giving you that particular analysis. For the first time when she released the song, I didn't see the TNS thing going on. Now, today, again, I find the same story and they're like, oh, well, they could be headed an uphill battle. I'm like, why? Well, it seems like they're really done. It could be what happened between, you remember what happened between Jeff Chiwa and Reddy and Wizzo? It may go like that because, I mean, what if Jeff Chiwa has shares in that house? The room already had it that he had shares in that house that she calls home. Too many what ifs, if you ask me. Too many what ifs. But apparently, they are in that place. Tebazi Kwasa, Sheba doesn't want to do drama. You know how Ugandan beef goes. It never really escalates too much. Until someone pulls out a gun and kills someone, I will never really take our beef seriously. Not that I want it to happen. Now, you need to understand, because it is my job to bring these stories, I actually have the right to come and tell you that's the truth. You know, even when I don't know much about it, when I can't speak much about it. But here's what I'm going to say, and this is an assumption. I do not think Jeff Chiwa and Sheba have any issues. I actually believe this is one of them local, you know, annoying strategies Ugandans have in our industry. It is always negativity will pull crowds towards you. That is the only thing they know. When they try to do some good, it's usually charity and it's measly. So the Ugandans don't care. I believe this is all a stunt. It can't be about releasing music, most definitely, because she has music out right now. But if y'all remember the issues that went on between Cindy and Sheba, the whole dummy artist. Now, Cindy, this is me trying to build up conspiracies so that I can give them something to work with, since they want a story in the headlines. Now, I believe that this whole cat and mouse that's going to be between Jeff Chiwa and Sheba in the next coming days or whatever, if it does happen, will actually not be for them. They are going to do it to attract the people towards them and then probably put word and news of Cindy's upcoming event. Remember, I told you, Cindy na ya ine chivulu. But then that would be, I think that would be me thinking so far ahead for the industry. But there's that option. Or probably there's more music that she's going to release and it needs some headway, but I don't think these two have issues. They're okay. Because when I talk to people who are actually close to Jeff and Sheba, they'll be like, but they ain't nothing. So, Ianze, kanaka kodionganyo katwala, I've taken it with a pinch of salt until I see some real. For now, I'll just go with my fallacies, my conspiracy theories, and entertain myself, given there's nothing much to do. Yep. It's been a while without me having, like, religious drama and banter. Josephine, tulude, tubade tuweso nyuwa bantu wa mkama, men of God. Okay. According to Josephine, she's saying that this nation didn't need a walk for corruption. This nation did not need a trek by the president 150 kilometers for patriotism. No, that is not where we needed to start from. This country doesn't need a ndagamuntu. No! And I conquer. Let us take it back to the churches. Now, last week, I had the words, they were running around, and someone sent it to me, and they're like, AT, can you believe Pastor Bujingo's estranged wife, Teddy, is actually saying she's ready to welcome him back with wide arms open? But I'm like, okay, then that's progress. What is his take on it? Because it's different when you want your man's back and he don't want back. He don't want back. But she's doing the Christian thing, though. That's what the Christian thing would be, isn't it? The earthly way, the secular way, is she would walk away, get her younger boy, bang on that, and love God and preach. But she's being Christian about it, so let's give her kudos for that. Now, like as though that wasn't confirmation enough for me, today, Zibadelero, Josephine, Lero, Sibioku Radio, one radio station, and we were listening in, me and Josephine were listening in, and she was telling us how she's ready, she's willing to take her man back. If he comes, ngabuli muloko, lebuli yombulokola, achimanyi, oino, kwe tonda, ajeye tonde, amaka yali redo, goddamn. And I'm looking at this woman like, honey, you dodged a bullet. Honey, you dodged an RPG. Honey, you dodged Nagasaki, Hiroshima, and everything in between by him walking away. He saved you. Who child? Ne manje bagamba. Mubagala na tosayo chicho. But one bana ikatubeko chetutekayo. I mean, she can be open to forgiveness. He has ridiculed her, said so many things he wasn't supposed to say about her, but we understand that's the power of strength. Because right now I feel like I'm in a Madea movie. Jesus Christ! Feels like one of them Tyler Perry movies. She's willing to take him back, but I have my questions. So when he comes back, what of Mchala Mto? What of the dreams and ambitions and goals that they have set for each other moving forward? Because she's expecting. She's heavy. So mugenda fumba mwembi oba agenda kujayo omwana we nga Sarah bwe yakola amulete mu makabana enze ndi kubuza like a Christian. I want someone to break down to me this dynamic, because there is no way on earth. So, what is her name? Oliyo mkaza mlala? Makula? Oyo. There is no way on earth she's going to let this man come back to you. She did all she had to do just to take him away from you. You think she's going to sit down and hold hands and just hold her hands and be like, you can go, I'm done with him? Are you crazy? From just being a church administrator, this woman is now given so much respect. It's not even about the money. The respect that goes with her name, just her being Mchala Msumba. Mubi manye bintu vya mwebye, mwe kubye mizi mwanti abalokore. Mami, babiraba mwita mami mchache. You think she's going to give that up? Wait, from just being a measly church administrator, simanya sirasha, akolera ku TV, simanya ku radio, they bought her own home. She has her own home. She has the respect of the church. She has the respect of the man. She is wanted. You think that she's going to wake up one day and just say it's okay? Bana isiganye mbune mukama tugamba mukama jaku nwandine entalo zanga. Ati mukama bwazirwana. Aziwangula. Na ye, the devil won't go down without a fight either. The fact that the devil penetrated this homestead a long time ago, it means the devil is still playing. Kwiso, bado, kwiso. Hey. Anyway, she's open to forgiveness. Let us wait and see if Bujingo will say something. But knowing Bujingo, he will not say something on another radio station. No. Katulinde service ya Sunday. Pinosula na bidwa kuku Sunday. His sermon is going to be about that. Kati Bujingo tacha alina church sermon is muchachi. Abu lidida. Na yuku vadabwachi wali. Bujingo can decide to lie about the Bible in ways that will make you understand it was written in the Bible. I've watched his sermons. I'm not even saying none. I mean, the Bible is the only one book that has a loophole for everything that we human beings do. The Bible can tell you not to kill and also tell you you can kill. That's the problem with the Bible. The Bible can tell you you can eat, but you also cannot eat. And then for each situation, it just fits the bill. That's why I put the Bible down. And that's why all these prophets, see, Simania pastors are playing tricks on you. Because they read the Bible. And they know your mentality. And they know how desperate you are. And they know how badly you want to see the Lord's favor work in you. So what do they need? It's just the Bible. Anyway, that's besides the point. When I quote Chala Bujingo, abagenda ku nsozi mukwate mukama muntegetege mugambe bannayo kumya omusajja w'omukazi tusabe.
Scoop was sponsored by